Welcome back to Design Bundle's YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal, and today we have a super fun summer project for you. Now, you can put this on a t-shirt, a sweatshirt if you want to, or you could even put it on a towel. But today, we're going to be putting this design on a tank top. So we're going to make a nice tank top to hang out at the beach today. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what design we're using today. Over here on designbundles.net, this is the file that we are using today. Like I said, this would be cute on a coffee cup, a tumbler. You could throw this on a beach towel, cell phone case, whatever you want to, but we are going to be creating a tank top today. So there's a few things I'm going to teach you. Number one, we're going to be using the Cricut Explore 3 today, and I'm going to show you using different materials from Cricut Smart Materials to then using a mat. So I'm going to show you that, as well as combining a couple colors on the same mat. So I'm going to show you guys that trick today as well. So like I said, this is the design we're using today, and it is only 1+ credit. So if you guys are new to our membership, the way that it works is you're going to get X amount of credits each month, depending on what tier you are on. So if you guys, say for example, are a Gold Plus member, I do believe you guys get around 50 credits a month, which ultimately means 50 free items. You're also going to get freebies on top of 15% off of your everyday purchases, etc. And even if you're a Gold Plus member, you're going to have access to our Designscape program. So you're going to get this for 1+ credit. And what's really awesome about our Plus credit membership is you don't have to take it to your cart. You're going to be able to just simply come right over here and click on download. Now you're also going to be able to come back and download over and over and over again as many times as you need to. So if you get a new computer or you lost your file, you can continue to download as many of those as you need. So we're going to be using this file, like I said, today. This would be so cute. As you can see on the black t-shirt, it looks almost like a chalk effect. So you would use white adhesive vinyl with those colors, and it would be gorgeous. But today we're going to be using this blue tank top just to see how it's going to work out. All right, so let's head on over to Cricut Design Space. All right, so now that we've hopped on over to Cricut Design Space, I've already uploaded my file, as you can see here. So we're going to cut it out not only in black, which I'm going to use Cricut Smart Materials for, and then we're going to cut out all of these colors here. So as you can see here, we have our black piece, and then we're going to have all of those colors like so. So what we can do is we can go in here and continue to change these. So if I want like a complete rainbow effect, or if I want to use, you know, basic vinyl, but then I want glitter or flock or holographic, I can do that all the way across the board, individual letters. Or I can do what they've done here, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep those same colors. I really like them. I think they're super cute. So what I want to actually do is attach those, because I want them to cut in that same spot. So whenever I go to line them up, they're going to be ready to go. Now, if you want to save materials, don't do anything, and then just go ahead and hit make it after you have sized it out, because Cricut's going to place those next to each other to save material. But if you want them to line up easy, then you're going to want to do what I'm going to do now. All right, so let me go ahead and grab my keyboard really quickly. We're going to start with this, and then we're going to go ahead and size it out. So the very first thing I want to do is I'm going to take this yellow E, I'm going to hold down the shift, and I'm going to click on that S. So you can see that both of these layers are highlighted now because they're a darker gray. And what I want to do is hit attach. All right, so if you clicked on attach, you are going to still have two pieces here, right? So they're going to be two files. Now, if you would actually click on weld, you're going to notice it becomes one file. So now they're up here as one file. So you can either weld them or attach them. If you want to bring that little list down, you can do so. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to click on weld. So we're going to do the same thing for the next color. I'm going to click on weld. And as you can see, once again, it's created one file. Click weld. And then we're going to do the same for the last one. Now, if you go to do this and you notice that all of the colors are changing all one color, you actually need to come up here once you have everything, and you're going to click ungroup. So if this is highlighted, then you need to ungroup everything. All right, so now we're ready to size everything out. So what we're going to do is you can either go across the screen like this to select everything, or you can come right up here to the top and click on select all, and it's going to select everything for us because we want to resize it all out together. So you can resize it out by dragging these little corners here, or you can do it right up here. And that's what I'm going to do today. So let's go ahead and figure out the measurements of our t-shirt. All right, so what we want to do is figure out the placement of where we're going to be putting our design, how wide do we want it to be. So what I'm going to be doing, as you can see here, this is our clear acrylic ruler. I did a tutorial on this. You guys can definitely check that out. I made this with my Glowforge, but we do have a tutorial showing you how to make one with your Cricut machine using a basic cardstock, if you will. But if you guys want to make your very own t-shirt ruler like this, that's acrylic, definitely check that out. We'll have a link above or down below. So what you can do is you can actually take this ruler and say, for example, I've got 5 inches and 5 inches. I know that this would be, 10 inches that I want. So wherever I want to line up my design here, so I'm thinking somewhere around probably 9 inches. And you can always confirm that by taking a ruler here. I like to use a sewing ruler. And then you can just measure across. So I'm thinking 9 inches should be pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead and do 9 inches wide. All right, so let's go ahead and plug that in. So we're going to come to the width here, and then we're going to go ahead and type out 9 inches and click enter. So this is going to give us that perfect size. So now we have a 9.9 by 6.79. So this is absolutely perfect, and we're ready to go. So let's go ahead and hit make it. And I've already got my machine turned on and ready to go. So here's a few options here. Now you notice a new one, which is on the card mat. Cricut has recently released a new mat. So if you guys are familiar with the card mat for the Cricut Joy, they now have one that can hold 4 cards that you can use for your Cricut Explorer or your Cricut Maker models. So you may see a new mat there. Now, the one that we want to choose today is multiple ways. If you're going to be using a mixture between smart materials and then your materials that need to go on a mat, you're going to choose multiple ways. If it was smart materials, just choose without a mat. If you're using a mat, so on and so forth. So we're going to choose multiple ways, and then we're going to hit continue. So from here, what we're going to do, this is our very first one. This is the one that we're actually doing with the smart materials. I want to go ahead and mirror, so we're going to turn that on. And then you're going to see it's telling me that I need to cut at least 8.5 inches. So they already come 13 inches wide. I need at least 8.5 inches. So I've already got that ready to go. And this one is without the mat. So I'm going to go ahead and drop down to my next one. And this one is going to be on the mat. So I'm just going to change that now. And I'm going to turn on mirror. So I'm going to go ahead and repeat the same process for the remaining ones that are going to be on the mat. All right, so now that we have everything on the correct mats and we have everything mirrored, you'd be ready to go. Now, I want to combine mine onto one mat. So I know that my N is going to be the coral color. The next one, which is the S and the E, is going to be yellow color. And then we have the mint. Now, the way that I can do this before I even get started, so I don't forget, I'm going to go ahead and layer these up. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take my colors here, so the colors of my materials, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to stack these in the order that they need to go onto my mat. So my first one here is that coral, the next one is the yellow, the next one is going to be that mint, and then we have our pink last. So I'm going to go ahead and flip these guys over. So this is the way that they're going to go on my mat. So now I'm going to start moving and combining. So if I go to my next mat here, I'm going to click on those three dots. I'm going to move object and I'm going to choose the mat. So we're choosing that first one, confirm, and I just need to bring it down. So we're just going to bring it down to the next one here. And then I'm going to go ahead and repeat this process. I'm going to scoot down to mat number 4, click on the dots here, move object, this mat here. And then I'm going to do the same thing. So it may try to move the first one. You want to make sure you keep that one in place. And then we're going to move the next one. Now you notice that I'm putting them a few inches down. So I know that this one's going to go between 1 and 2 inches. This one here is going to go between 3 and 5 inches, and then so on and so forth. This one's going to go between 5 and 8 inches. And then we're going to add our last one. So for the last one here, I'm going to click on that three dots, move object, bring it over here, click on it. And we're going to move it down here as well. So I'm going to go ahead and do 9 inches below. So I just like to drop them down just a smidge. All right. So each of these, I'm going to go ahead and cut them 2 1/4. So I need 2 1/4 by 6. So I'm going to do 7. So 2 1/4 by 7 on each of these. And then we're going to layer them on the mat. So let's go ahead and send this over. So let's go ahead and hit continue. And then we are going to go ahead and choose our materials here. So our very first one, which is up here, is going to be our smart materials. So I'm going to go ahead and hit smart iron on, and then it's ready to go. So that way then, while this one is cutting, I can start working on these. So it's telling me it is ready to go. So I'm going to go ahead and bring the camera up here so you guys can see. All right, so what we're gonna do, that glossy side is gonna go down. We're gonna load it. You're just gonna go ahead and hit that arrow to take it in. It's gonna load it in, make sure you have enough materials, and then the go button is gonna start flashing. All right, so I've hit that go button. So while we're doing that, I'm gonna go ahead and drop the camera down below so I can show you guys how to load your mat. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and bring in my paper trimmer here, and we're gonna cut these down, like I said, to that 2 1/4. I'm gonna do 2 1/4, and I'm gonna go by color, so that way I don't get confused. So 2 1/4, trim that down, and then I'm gonna go ahead and cut it to that 7. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get that right there at that 7, and then we're gonna start to load these. So as I do that, I'll bring in my mat. I'm gonna load my first color here. That way I don't confuse myself. So I remember that that one's coral. We're gonna go down the row here as they are stacked correctly. We're gonna go in here. We're gonna do 2 1/4, trim it down. And then we're gonna get it by that 7. All right. Now this one, if you remember, we started it at the 3. And I go ahead and get this one down. Make sure you're keeping them right at the top of that mark, as you're gonna keep them, you know, you wanna place them wherever you have them on that mat. So then we're gonna go to the next one. We're gonna do that 2 1/4. 2 1/4 by 7, all right. And then we're gonna do that same thing, which is gonna be 6-inch mark, all right. And then we're gonna go ahead and do the last one. All right, so we've got 2 1/4, cut it, and then we're gonna cut it by that 7. There we have it. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and load our very last color here, just like that. So now we're ready to take it over and load it. We're gonna go ahead and unload, and we're gonna swap out. So for this one, I need to head back over to Cricut Design Space so we can switch our material. All right, so over here, we're just gonna go ahead and choose Everyday Iron-On for this. I'm using Caesar Easy Weed, but it's just the same as Everyday Iron-On for those settings. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get ready to load in. So I've done the same thing. I've hit that load button. I'm gonna wait for it to give us the go sign. So I'm gonna go ahead and trim this up here. I'm gonna go ahead and trim off our excess because I cut this a little bit longer just to make sure I had enough. And then I'm gonna trim off my excess sides here. All right, so now we're gonna hit go. And we're gonna go ahead and let that cut out for us. So now ultimately, I only had 2 mats technically, one without and then 1 mat. So that way I'm not having to load over and over and over again. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and drop this down so we can weed it. All right, so let's go ahead and weed out the Cricut Smart Materials first. So we're gonna go ahead and get a corner there and we are gonna start weeding. So whenever it comes to the Cricut Smart Materials, I do think they work great, but their backing is thicker. So keep in mind, it may take you a little bit longer to weed compared to using something like VCs or Easy Weed. So you guys will notice that here in just a second. So I'm gonna go ahead and speed this up. All right, so now that we have weeded all of this out, we're gonna go ahead and get ready to start weeding our easy weed. So we're going to just peel this off of the mat like so. We're gonna do those one at a time. Now, once again, if you wanted to save material, you definitely could have done that. It would have been the same thing. It would have combined them next to each other and you actually wouldn't have needed, you probably would have only needed half of each material. All right, so let's go ahead and weed out our remaining colors. So as you can see, whenever it comes to Caesar Easy Weed, it's gonna weed so much easier. Now, obviously there's not very much to weed of each color, but Caesar Easy Weed, as well as if you were using like a Cricut Everyday Iron-On, if it's not Smart Materials, those things are a little bit easier. StarCraft, all of your basics are gonna be easy compared to your Smart Materials is on a very thick backing. The reason why it's on a thick backing is to help carry it through the machine. First things first, what we're gonna do is we're gonna line up our design. So this is gonna be the piece that's gonna go down first. So whatever piece is going on your t-shirt first, you want that to be your bottom base. Then it's gonna be by color. So of course, summer starts with an S. You want to make sure you have the correct S. So we're going to go ahead and start off with this one. So we're just going to go ahead and make sure we line these up here. There we go. This Chasing Sunshine is the most cutest design. I love it so much. And like I said, the colors that were already played out here for us, I just love them so much. So I just went ahead and went with it. So as you guys can see here, there is our finished design. It came out super cute. So once you have it combined like this, you can either store it for later. You can put it on a piece of parchment paper, store it for later until you're ready to press it. Once you're ready to press it, we're going to go ahead and bring in our t-shirt here. I'm going to bring in my Cricut pad. We're going to bring in our t-shirt. Today I'm using the Cricut Easy Press 3. So what you can do with a shirt like this, where it has a razor back like this, So what you're going to do is load this inside of the mat. So this is just going to ultimately become a pressing pillow to avoid those seams. I'm going to go ahead and slide this right inside. You just want to make sure that you're keeping your t-shirt nice and straight. All right, so now that we have our t-shirt ready to go, we have our design ready to go. To find the center of your design, you're just simply going to fold it in half, pinch it to get the center mark. So you're going to have a little pinch mark there. Go ahead and fold it one more time just to make sure. So wherever you have that little mark like so, that's going to be your center. Now, if you make one of our acrylic rulers here, you're simply going to pop this right up here around that neckline. You're going to have an arrow here, and then what we're going to be able to do is line this up with that arrow. So we're going to take where we made that crease mark, and then we're just going to go ahead and line this up with that arrow. And I want this design, which I'm going to go off of the dot of the eye, not the top of the sun here, and I'm going to get that at the bottom of the ruler, so just like so, and then I can remove the ruler out of the way. All right, so this is ready to go. So now that our bottom base is exactly where we want it to be, I could go ahead and go through here and peel up that sunshine. So this should ultimately stick all together, just like so. So we're going to set our word sunshine out of the way, and we're going to get ready to press this. I'm going to take my iron right on top, and I'm going to press this in two presses. So I only need, I'm going to do a 5-second tack down, because whenever it comes to Cricut materials, I have found that a 5-second tack down is better than two. So whenever it comes to the Caesar Easy Weed, I do a 2-second tack down. But like I said, the Cricut materials does need a few more seconds. Now, another thing with the Cricut materials, I would let it cool down for 2 seconds, almost come to a complete cool before you try to peel it away. All right, so now that I've let it cool somewhat, I'm gonna go ahead and start to peel. So it's not that it needs more heat. So if you ever go to peel this and it's starting to come back up with you, it's not that it needs more heat. You just need to let it cool for a few seconds. All right, so now let's move on to our Caesar Easy Weed. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna line that word right back up here, just like so. Now, this is also going to prevent shrinking. So in between layers, it's going to prevent any sort of shrinking. So I'm going to go ahead and leave down our first color, and I'm going to peel up the next. Now what we want to do is protect the rest of it. So the same cover sheet that we used just a second ago, you're just going to go right back on top there, and then we're going to press. Now once again, I'm only going to press for 2 seconds. I don't need very long because it is the Caesar Easy Weed. And then we'll go ahead and peel this back up, and then we're going to remove this one. There we go. Perfect. Like I said, you only need 2 seconds for that. All right, so let's go ahead and move into our next one. So we're going to go ahead and drop down that next color there. We're going to go back on top here and press again for 2 seconds. Now I am pressing today 315 for 30 seconds total, which is going to be the end result, but we are doing 315. And then we're just going to line this one up so that way it'll be ready to go. And then we are going to cover this one. We're going to go over one more time for 2 seconds. There we go. How cute is this? It's coming along amazing. So like I said, you could do whatever colors your heart desires. And once again, if you put this on a black t-shirt, it's going to look like chalk, like you did a chalk I'm like on a chalkboard. You get what I'm saying? Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to do our final press. So this time we're doing it for the 30 seconds. I'm going to do this side first. So 315 for 30 seconds. We're pressing this side, and then I'll scoot it over, and we'll press again for 30 seconds. All right, we're going to scoot it over, and we're going to press one more time. Now, in case you're wondering about pressing again, so I'm going over an area that's already been done, if it's going to hurt anything, and it definitely will not. Now, if I was using a bigger, so if I was using the Cricut, the 10 by 12, I would have done this in one press or a bigger heat press, like a craft press or even a 15 by 15, etc. Obviously, you would only need to do it in the one press. You'd still have to layer, but that final press would be one time. All right, so we've got 0 seconds there. We're going to go ahead and peel. And then we're going to go ahead and peel one more time. And there you have it. How super cute did this come out? I really love the colors here. And this is a mint on top of that blue. And you can see how you can still see that. I really love the font of this design, Chasing Sunshine. It is just so cute. Imagine this even on a pillowcase. Lots of different things that you guys can do with it. And there you guys have it. I think this came out so cute. I'm in love with it. Now make sure if you guys recreate this, whether you throw it on a tote bag, a pillowcase, whatever you do with it, we wanna see. Use the hashtag design bundle so we can check it out. Or even better, join our Facebook community group so you guys can share it and give tons of inspiration. You can also find lots of inspiration from tons of other crafters just like yourself. We have giveaways over there, freebies. So definitely make sure you guys check it out. We have it linked down below. If you guys have enjoyed this, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. And we'll see you guys on the next one. Bye for now.